I'm black, I'm gay, and I'm a priest. I never thought I'd find a church in Kenya where I could be all three. This is my story. I come from a family of preachers. Both my parents are evangelists, and so is my brother. So from an early age, I knew I wanted to be a priest. When I turned 12, I realized I was different. While my friends started writing love letters to girls, I wasn't interested. But if a boy I was close with missed school, I'd cry and go looking for them. Then when I was 15, some boys at school were caught having sex. Our teacher told us they were homosexual, gay. It was the first time I had a word for who I was and what I was feeling. I realized I was gay too. But then the teacher told us being gay was an African. He said gay boys had demons that they needed to be prayed for and delivered. I felt ashamed. So I prayed for God to take the queerness away from me. Church leaders told me if I confessed my sin, I would be delivered from the gay demon. So that's what I did. I testified. I told everyone in church that being gay was a sin and that God had freed me from homosexuality. People would shout and cheer, but I hadn't really changed, and I knew it. Yet, I still wanted to be a priest. So I studied hard at university and was ordained in a mainstream church. I chose to live a celibate life. I couldn't change my sexuality, but I decided not to act on any feelings of attraction. And that was painful. One day I confessed to a friend about my struggle. Next thing I knew, word spread that I was gay. I had been outed. People in my church were gossiping about me and calling me a sinner. So I ran away. I went to study abroad. And that's where I found myself. I met an African Pentecostal scholar who interpreted the Bible in a different way. He did not preach hate. He taught me God loves queer people too. That was my salvation moment. I stopped looking at God as a boogeyman ready to strike me dead. From then on, I saw God as a friend, the one who made me and all queer people. My walk with God became beautiful. I wondered if I could find Christians who believed the same back home in Kenya. After searching for a while, I eventually found a Christian community that welcomes queer people, just as we are. The first time I went to the queer-affirming church, I couldn't control my tears. For the first time in my life, I saw ordinary Kenyans, gay, lesbian, trans, and non-binary, worshipping God together free from shame. In that moment, I wrote in my diary, "The Holy Spirit dwells in queer bodies." Finally, I felt able to say, "I am gay, I am black, I'm Christian, I'm a priest." I felt that God had set me free. Healing became possible. I have never looked back. 2023 has been a sad year for Africa. Countries like Kenya and Ghana want stronger anti-gay laws. If passed, that could make it illegal for queer people like me and my church community to gather. The passing of the anti-gay law in Uganda has also made people bolder in expressing their homophobia openly. But my community gives me strength. They have given me a new mission to spread God's love for queer people. I am not just a priest of the church. I am a priest of the world.